I on me. What do you know about me? Huh? You know what I think about? When I'm alone, thinking about what do you know about me? What would you like to know about me? Would you like to know how much potential I have? Would you like to know that I'm a sinner? Misfit. I'm an open book. I'll tell you anything. Think that you do not have the courage to ask me the questions. What do you want to know? You think you got some exclusive right? No, but what happens inside of here, oh, I could tell you stories, you know, a human being is you don't slow down and think about it. But if you did, I gotta tell you, watch out. You don't know what you're gonna find. Start looking in another person's mind. Oh, yeah. I was crying tears just the other day. Smacked upside the head. 2x4 called Sublime. You know, Sublime? You know, there's a lot of thinkers out there, historically, who had their thoughts about the sublime, people like Longinus, Immanuel Kant, Thomas Carlyle, people who study aesthetics, Arthur Schopenhauer. These are philosophical types. Get into the nitty-gritty of reality. And I'll tell you what I think. You know, in the sublime, when you know why you are alive. And if you don't know, you're gonna want a little bit of this. I'm gonna tell you something, you can't have it. You cannot. This sublime is for me. And me alone, so you can rub your paws off of it. And don't even try to get those suckers on me, you parasite. I would tell you, I am an open book. I like to just put my cards out on the table. Trust is a big thing. I cannot trust you. You may look like me, you may act like me, but you may not be trustworthy. And you know why? You know why I can spot you types a mile away? Because you don't got that look in your eye. Or you do. It's the crazy look. It's the scattered look. You don't know why you are on this planet. You don't know the sublime. You're just going through the motions. People like me, we may be sinners. We may have a lot of potential, but we are dialed in. Dialed in. Trust me, you'd know it if you were. You wouldn't have to pretend nothing. People would respect you. I wouldn't be talking trash like they talk trash today. No. That's gone. Would you believe me if I told you that I was a cowboy in my previous life? I was out there with the cattle in the valleys, the mountains, with the coyotes. And I thought the meaning of life was just out there. Experience the sublime, the mystery of nature. But now, it's different for me because I was born in a city after I passed away as a cowboy. Now I'm walking around. The best I can do on my best day is to regard my fellow human beings as cattle. Like I'm on a horse galloping through the city, rounding up my cattle. That's how I know I was a cowboy in a former life, because I got the herding instinct. Why are these people acting like cattle? Because they're not in touch with the sublime. They don't know why they are alive. They don't know the mystery. Mystery. Mystery will tell you everything, but it's not a mystery you're going to understand. It's a mystery that you live. Like a cowboy would live it. I know that you don't know what I know. What I'm talking about. And that is okay. You don't have to know. But what's most important is that your brain is blown. Your mind is blown. The sense that you try to make out of everything has got to collapse. Because that's a cage. You feel me? That is a cage. You can spend a lot of time in that cage. It's become your whole reality, hasn't it? Your whole prison. What you want to do, what every cattle does, you want to find more cattle just like you, a herd. And some like me, a sinner, walks through town. And you look at me with suspicion in your bovine eyes. You're like, that human is up to no good. That human may be after me. That human may have wicked design. I can assure you that I do not. Not toward my fellow human beings. I do not have a wicked design toward them. What I want for them is something I want for the people that I hold dear. I want them to know why they are alive. I do not want them to continue to wander through the city like cattle, with that absent gaze in their eyes, with so little sentience. Their minds are so small. Their minds are too small to be blasted open. That's the problem. Being cattle in a herd in a city. You have no sense of the sublime. And then a cowboy comes walking through town. He's got his swagger. He's got his cowboy hat. He's even got his pistols. His leather boots. And most importantly, he's a sinner. He's got that look in his eye of the sublime. That's why we romanticize the Wild West, as we think that those cowboys and that frontier life and those caravans and those saloons was sublime, because those people were living on the edge, the frontier. They had death in front of them, death to the side of them, and death behind them, death below them, and even death above them. And when you have death all around you, that's your ticket. That's how you know you are alive, and that's the only way that you can sense the sublime, is when life and death are staring at each other. You weren't gonna get it any other way. You gotta look it in the eye. You cannot turn away, and that is how you get your sublime. I may not know much. I may be a sinner. I may have a lot of potential. But one thing I want is for you and me to come to an understanding. I don't want you to continue the way that you've been going, because it's not good for you. You're bottoming out. You are. There's a hole somewhere, and you're just leaking, aren't you? You're leaking. You are constantly leaking. I can see it. You can't. But the reason you don't know the mystery of why you are alive, you don't know the mystery of feeling alive. You don't know that sublime because you are leaking. Do you understand what it means to leak? You don't. You don't even know why you don't understand, I'll tell you. Because you have been leaking since the day that you were born. When you're walking around and the people around you are just walking around and you're all just walking around, spinning about. Not knowing the mystery of being alive, not feeling the sublime in your bones with your mind blown, then you're leaking. That leaking is your fear of death. That's why you cannot face it. You cannot face the death. And when you cannot face the death, you do not know why you are alive. And I will tell you something, when you cannot face the death, you get caught up in here. You get caught up in here with the concepts, caught in the concepts. And then you're terrified, then you've got to run the other direction. Because a thought against death ain't ever going to work. Because death is a thought. It's the one that horrifies you. One thought versus another, and you scream! Bloody Mary, bloody murder. What I want for you is to stand still amid the cattle, amid the herd, amid the masses. Now watch these ignorant bovines walk about without a sense of the sublime, without knowing why they are alive. Don't give up. I was a cowboy in a former life. I'm a ne'er-do-well, misfit sinner. In this life, you don't have to be all that. No. You think other people got it so good. Maybe you envy them. But if you find the sublime, you will not be a loser. You will have no reason to fear that your life is in vain. Because the sublime is who you are. The sublime is life itself, but not life contracted away from life. It's life fully inhabiting life. And I know it sounds ridiculous, but it's because you're locked up here. Once you're living it, and there's no leakage, then you will simply understand that you are the sublime.